Okay, moving on to problem number 27. Just to give you the idea, what we are doing in remeasurement of liability, whenever there is change in reassessment of lease term or purchase or renewal option, you are going to revise the liability based on the new amount, and in certain situation using the old discounting rate, and in certain situation new discounting rate, and whatever the change you got, the revised liability what you got is going to be adjusted in ROU asset. Okay, let us do a problem now. Question number 27. Entity W entered into a contract for retail store with entity J on January 1st, 2017. The initial term of the lease is 5 years with renewal option for further 3 years. Annual lease payments for initial term and renewal term is 1 lakh and 1,10,000 respectively. That means, please observe my dear friends, 1 lakh is for 5-year term and 1,10,000 is for 3-year terms. 1 lakh for 5 years and 1,10,000 for 3 years. The annual lease payment will increase based on the annual increase in the CPI at the end of the preceding year. For example, the payment due on 1/1/2018 will be based on CPI available on 31st December 2017. CPI means Consumer Price Inflation Index. Basically, is used for assessing the inflation, growth rates, because rental amount should increase in tandem with the inflation. Therefore, they said it is based on the previous year's CPI. Entities W incremental borrowing rate on the lease inception is 5% and 6% respectively. That is, at the beginning it is 5%, and on the 1/1/2010 it is 6% on the revised date, the date on which you are doing remeasurement of liability, new discounting rate is 6%. CPI at lease commencement date and on 1/1/2010 is 120 and 124.8 respectively. So CPI has become 120. 120 was on 1/1/2017, that is on the date of entering into contract, and this became 124.8. Therefore, increase is 4.8, and 4.8 divided by 120 into 100. So that you get the increase in percentage terms, which happens to be 4%. So what we are going to do, we will take 1 lakh for lease payments, but from 1/1/2020 onwards, your lease payment will increase by 4%, because they said the lease rental is going to increase by the CPI growth rate. So when it is happening, it is happening on 1/1/2020. So we are starting on 1/1/2017, and look at the last sentence. Assume the payments are made at the beginning of each year. So first year 1/1/2017 is 1 lakh. Second year 1/1/2018 is 1 lakh. Third year 1/1/2019 is 1 lakh. Fourth year 1/1/2020 will not be 1 lakh, because as on this date CPI is changed, it is 1 lakh plus 4%. So on 1/1/2020 it will be 1,04,000, and remaining year also 1,04,000 and 1,04,000 and so on. And that 1,10,000 renewal period will not be 1,10,000, that will also increase by 4%. So let us read the question, then I'll give you the lease rental part. On the lease commencement date, entity did not have significant economic incentive to exercise the renewal option. In the first quarter of 2020, entity W installed unique lease improvements into retail store with an estimated 5-year economic life. Entity W determined that it would only recover the cost of improvement if it exceeds the renewal option, creating a significant economic incentive to extend. Is Entity W required to remeasure the lease in the first quarter of 2020? Assume the payments are made at the beginning of each year. We have seen this, my dear friends, during lease term. Originally, you take certain period number of years, assuming that you are not going to exercise or you are going to exercise. But in this case, on 1/1/2017, at inception, you are not having any intention to extend the contract. Therefore, you are taking original period of 5 years. So, as on 1/1/2017, your lease rental intention is 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, and 1 lakh. 1 lakh per annum for 5 years. That was your intention. But now what happened? Because of the revision and some improvement made in the premises on the leased asset, you are telling it is going to be renewed. Because if you don't renew, this amount what you spend on improvements cannot be recovered. Therefore, this is accounting for reassessment of lease term. And when lease term is reassessed, the liability also need to be reassessed. And any changes, you should account it in ROU asset. Okay. So when are you doing it? You are doing in the first quarter of 2020. Remember, my dear friends, the payments are made at the beginning of each year. So 1/1/2017 is done, 1/1/2018 is done, 1/1/2019 is done. You are supposed to make the payment of 1/1/2020. Before making the payment, you are making this change. Therefore, as on 1/1/2020, before making this change, before making the payment of lease, you have to give the effect of this change on 1/1/2020, that is on the fourth year. How much amount lease rental? Not 1 lakh, because I told you this CPI from 120 has become 124.8. There's a growth of 4%. Therefore, when I'm reassessing, I'll take the new liability amount. So in the reassessment case, three factors are considered now. First factor is the number of years remaining are supposed to be 2 years. Out of 5 years, 3 years over. So remaining supposed to be 2 years, but plus 3 years I'll take because I'm extending it. My intention is now to extend. Lease term is revised. So one, lease term is revised. Second, lease payments are revised because of CPI. And the third, discounting rate is also changed. So three things are to be accounted now while calculating the numbers. On 1/1/2020, 1/1/2021, 1/1/2022, 2023, and 2024. Totally remaining 5 installments, because 3 over, remaining is 5. That is, in the current lease term, it was 2 more years plus 3 extended years. So this will not be 1 lakh. Plus 4% growth rate. So this is 1,04,000. This is 1,04,000. So with this 1,04,000, 1,04,000, our original 5-year term got over. Our original 5-year term got over. Now remaining is supposed to be how much? Remaining is supposed to be 1,10,000. Correct? Remaining to be 1,10,000 for 3-year period. But that 1,10,000 is now reassessed by what percentage? The CPI inflation, 124.8, 4% growth rate. So on 1,10,000, 4% growth rate becomes 1,14,400. So these are the lease rental for the remaining term in or at the time of reassessment of liability due to reassessment of lease term. Let us compute the number now. First, let us start from the date on which you started the lease liability. That is when the contract started. On 1/1/2017, your lease liability will be remember payment made at the beginning of each year. So year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Your original assessment is only 5 years. Now what you're calculating is original assessment, not the revised one. Therefore, lease payment, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. This is what you thought at the beginning on 1/1/2017. We had to come to the reassessment stage. This is original terms, original calculation at inception stage, 1/1/2017. Discounting factor at the rate of 5%. That was the number originally. My dear friends, can you tell me what would be the discounting rate when you are making the payment at the beginning of each year? One, because first year no discounting, because payment made at the beginning, not at the end. If payment made at the end, you can do 1/1.05. But payment made at the beginning, so first payment, take the discounting factor as present value 1 rupee, today value, no discounting is to be applied. Next year 0.952, next year 0.907, 1/1.05, you keep on doing it. That is 0.864, 0.823, and so on. Remember, these are all the payments made at the beginning of each year. So 1 lakh at the end, beginning of first year, 1 lakh at the beginning of second year, 1 lakh at the beginning of third year, 1 lakh at the beginning of fourth year, 1 lakh at the beginning of fifth year. So actually these discounting rates are end of previous year. That is, this 0.952 is payment made at the beginning of second year equivalent to payment made at the end of first year. Okay. Now discounted cash flow, multiply 1 lakh into 1 is 1 lakh, 1 lakh into 0.952, 95,200, 1 lakh into 0.907, 9,700, 1 lakh into 0.864, 86,400, 1 lakh into 0.823, 8,300, total 4,54,600. Now this was the amount on 1/1/2017. Since we don't have any other adjustments like initial direct cost, lease prepayments, lease incentives, this amount itself is ROU asset also on that date. Okay. Now, for the reassessment now, this is 4,54,600 on 1/1/2017. Now on 1/1/2020, there is a reassessment of liability because of the factors we discussed. So I need to compute the carrying amount on that date. Therefore, carrying amount will be beginning, you are going to charge 4,54,600, that is a liability to be recognized. On that, interest is going to be 5%. I'm computing the carrying amount on 1/1/2020, opening balance plus interest minus lease payment, closing balance. This closing balance is opening for next year. Opening balance plus interest minus lease payment, closing balance. This closing balance is opening for subsequent year, and so on till 1/1/2020. I should do it. Can you tell me the interest for the first year? 4,54,600 into 5%. How much you are getting? Zero. Why? Payment made at the beginning of first year. Payment made at the beginning means no interest. Zero interest. Fine. So lease payment of 1 lakh is made at the beginning. It's like a down payment in case of your installment or higher purchase problems. Correct? So 4,54,600 minus 1 lakh, 3,54,600. In the year 2, 3,54,600 on that 5%. 17,730 minus 1 lakh lease payment, closing balance 2,72,330. 3,54,600 plus 17,730 minus 1 lakh is 2,72,330. My dear friends, please note this. 17,330 is not first year interest. 730 is not second year interest. It's first year interest. Because these amounts are at the beginning of each year. 1 lakh payment made at the beginning of each year. Therefore, 17,730 is actually related to year 1. Because this year means, in this column, I mean beginning of each year. Therefore, next year 2,72,330 becomes the opening balance. On that interest of 13,417 minus 1 lakh, 1,85,947. This is the amount at the end of third year or beginning of fourth year. I don't take 1 lakh lease payment. 1 lakh lease payment is made, to be made, but I don't take it because on this date, revision of liability is happening. And on this date, CPA also given. So lease liability to be remeasured and discounting rate is to be considered at new rate. And also, lease term remaining will be for new number of years, reassessment of lease term. Therefore, before you making this payment, you need to remeasure this liability. So carrying amount at the present value is 1,85,947. Now we should go for remeasurement because for the changes that have taken place. So remeasurement on 1/1/2020, remaining 5 years. Hope you remember, original 5 years plus 3, but this 3 was not there earlier, but now we are going to consider it. Out of 5 years, 3 years over, 1/1/2017, 2018, 2019, 3 years is over, remaining is 2 years, that is 2020-2021, and remaining 3 years, so totally 2 plus 3, 5 years we need to do reassessment. And what is lease liability? Not 1 lakh. Because of CPI, 4% growth rate, 1,04,000, 1,04,000, two years in the original term. In the remaining, 1,10,000 was there. I repeat this calculation. You remember, 1,10,000 was there, but we don't take 1,10,000. We don't take 1,10,000 because growth rate is 4%. So 1,10,000, growth rate 4% is 1,14,400 for remaining term. Until we get the remaining CPI, this used to be our, this will be our lease payment, 1,10,000 plus CPI inflation of 4.8%. And discounting rate should be revised rate, new rate at the time of remeasurement. Please revisit this chart. When your lease term is reassessed, you're going with revised rate. Lease term, revised rate, So at 6% you do discounting. Again, this is payment at the beginning of each year. So first payment is one discounting factor, then 1/1.06 is 0.943 equal to 0.890 equal to 0.840 equal to 0.792. Then multiply these two, 1,04,000 into 1, that is 1,04,000. 1,04,000 into 0.943, 98,072. 1,14,400 in the new term, into 0.890, 101,816, 1,14,400 into 0.840, 96,96, 1,14,400 into 0.792, 90,605, do the total, 4,90,589. So 4,90,589 is the revised liability, and original liability is 1,85,947. The difference is to be adjusted with ROU of the asset. Let us see what is that ROU of the asset. Originally, when you acquired, it was 4,54,600. We just calculated, no? This number, 4,54,600. That is the liability amount, that is the asset amount at inception stage. And depreciation, you are going to provide on straight line basis for a period of 5 years, original 5 years. So divided by 5, and 3 years is over, 17 over, 18 over, 19 over. So divided by 5 into 3, you get cumulative depreciation of 2,72,760. What is remaining amount on 1/1/2020? 1,81,840. Now, this is the carrying amount of liability assets, and this is the carrying amount of liability. 1,85,947 was liability, and 1,81,840 is asset. Now liability is to be remeasured, therefore corresponding effect will go for asset. Liability to be remeasured at 4,98,589. Liability original 1,85,947, revised 4,95,89, increase differential 304,642, that should be adjusted in ROU. So journal entry will be ROU of the asset to lease liability 304,642. So this 1,81,840 will increase by 304,642. Ultimately, revised ROU will be this new number, 4,86,482. Existing amount of 1,81,840 plus revised liability differential of 304,642. If I add both, I get 4,86,482. On that remaining years, we are going to provide depreciation over a period of remaining term of 5 years. And what will be the revised liability amount now? This will be the new number, 4,90,589, because from 1,85,947, we have increased by 304,642. Ultimately, it will become 4,90,589. So liability remeasured, corresponding effect is given on ROU of the asset and depreciate over remaining useful life. And lease liability, the revised lease liability, new lease liability for the remaining term at discount, new discounting rate will be followed by amortization cost for the remaining period. So this is the problem on lease reassessment of liability. Then we'll do now next lease modification, and lease modification also will have lease liabilities. So all those complex structure problems, we'll take it up in the next problem. So practice well. And thank you for watching.